With Grand Theft Auto 5, Rockstar have tried to reimagine the open world game in a number of ways. The game world is beautiful, massive, and diverse. A sprawling, satirical reimagining of modern Southern California, covering mountains and oceans, expensive stores and strip malls, urban decay and untouched wilderness, beaches and backwoods, the sublime and the ridiculous, greed and hypocrisy.
You tell me exactly what you want, and I will very carefully explain to you why it cannot be.
What?
So what are we doing here?
We're working, amigo.
For the first time, the game features not one, but three would-be heroes.
So now what?
Michael, a once successful bank robber, and now less successful family man.
You know, you're a real asshole.
What did you just say to me?
Stop it! You're ruining my yoga!
Franklin, a hungry street hustler convinced he's surrounded by morons.
We can't repo the assets of a dead man, big sitting cheap asshole.
And then there's Trevor.
Fuck.
The less said about him, the better. Introducing three lead characters transforms both the narrative into one interwoven story and the structure of individual missions. Players can cut between vantage points.
Yeah, I can use a little backup here.
And from one high-octane moment to another.
Gotcha.
He's got support!
Get us out of here!
Roger that!
This helps to give missions new levels of diversity and intensity.
Damn.
When not on a mission, the use of three lead characters also allow for a touch of voyeurism, as you can drop in at any moment and find out what your new friends have been up to as they go about their days.
Jeez, Pop, too much more of that and maybe I won't be dead by 35.
The world is not only huge, it's packed with a vast array of things to see and do. Cars to customize, planes to fly, clothes to buy, sports to play, nirvanas to pursue, oceans to dive, animals to spot, hunt, and be hunted by, freaks to watch, meet, and befriend.
Now get the hell out of here!
Bounties to hunt, and on and on.
How have you been?
Oh! Simply wonderful. And you?
Somewhere stuck between joyful and peachy.
There's also been a huge focus on mechanics in the game to make every aspect as fun and fluid as it is broad. Everything from driving and shooting to tennis and bike riding feels fun and responsive. However, alongside all of this leisure, people also have to take care of business. For all their pretensions, these men are dangerous thieves.
It's an industrial area, right? So I'm thinking vehicles. Trash truck to block, tow truck to sack.
To survive, they have to set up and pull off a series of increasingly audacious heists.
Gentlemen, some plans for your attention?
The player sets these up themselves, then decides how they execute them and with whom.
Two ways I see of doing this. We go in smart.
Let's go.
Or we go in loud and dumb.
Let's go!
Ladies and gentlemen, this is your moment! Please don't make me ruin all the great work your plastic surgeons have been doing.
After the take is divided, you decide what to spend your money on. Anything from sensible investments, like tattoos and fast cars, to risky ventures like stocks and Los Santos real estate. And then there's Grand Theft Auto Online, which we will show you properly soon.